Nobody knows the Son except the Father. And no one knows the Father except the Son, and to him that the Son has given a revelation. Christ came to reveal the Father to us. The Father did not come to reveal to us the Son, but the Son came to reveal to us the Father. So if the Son has revealed the Father to you, then you shall begin to know God as a Father, understand him as a Father, approach him as a Father, live with God as a Father, treat him as a Father, go before him as a Father, and entertain God as a Father. Let me go back to the topic. When they didn't have the answer, it took the hand of God to open heaven and to release a revelation upon Peter. And Peter said, "You are the Christ," meaning the anointed one, "the Son of the living God." If you were Jesus on that day, if I were Jesus on that day, I would be so foolish to tell people, beginning Peter McCoffey. Jesus did not tell them to appreciate Peter, but he spoke to Peter and said, "Simon, the son of Jonah, flesh and blood has not revealed this one to you, but my Father in heaven." Now, God is spirit, and flesh and blood do not give life. And when we confess our faith, we begin to live by it. So the flesh did not bring the confession, because the flesh could not receive a revelation. The revelation from God is not received by the flesh. The revelation from God is received in the spirit. So Jesus is telling Peter, the flesh and blood has not revealed this unto you, but my Father, God who is the spirit, my Father in heaven, have revealed this one to you. And now that you have declared me the Christ, I also tell you, you are Peter. Glory to God. Now, Peter means Petrock. In another language, I don't want to go to that one. Or the word Peter means a rocky man. And he says, I also tell you that you are Peter, meaning you are a strong man. You are a man of encouragement. You are somebody who can support his brothers. After addressing Peter as a person, he began to address the confession of Peter. And he says, upon this rock. Here is where we miss the point. Many people say Jesus founded his church on Peter. No. He had addressed Peter and ended it there. And now he's telling him, upon this rock. Which rock? The rock of the confession of the Lordship of Jesus Christ. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory which overcomes the world, is our faith. Anything built on the faith will overcome the world. And Jesus is telling Peter, upon this rock, the rock of confession, the Lordship of Jesus, upon your confession, upon the rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail over it. It means I am building a church which will overcome the world. There is nothing that overcomes the world rather than what is built on the faith. Glory to God. Because faith is the victory which overcomes the world, and everything that is founded on the rock of faith